A quick look on how to do a recording with Firefox. Firefox is a good all-around solution because it's multi-platform, you can install it on every operating system, and you can also use it to record your script for OctoPerf. So a first recommendation would be to use a new private window functionality from Firefox. This way you can start a new session without any cookie, without any cache. That's a great way to start a recording from scratch. And then we're going to use the developer tools that are built in Firefox. So we can open them with F12, or you can use the menu right here, go to Web Developer, and then select Toggle Tools, which I already did here. Now, the only thing you have to change on the developer tool screen is to check persist log if it's not already there, because you want the traffic to be saved all along the recording. So now we have to go to our application. So I'm going to use this demo application we have right here. And as you can see, the traffic is being recorded. So I'm going to enter the store and I'm going to record a navigation through this application. So first we'll go to the sign-in page right here, and then we'll submit with the default credential, and I would like to also purchase a product from this web store. So just remember one thing, we will automatically create transactions after the recording based on the timestamps inside this recording. So you want to pace your recording and wait a few seconds on every page so that we are able to do that in the end. So here, that's why I'm waiting a bit, at least a few seconds on every page. And this way, transaction will be created automatically for me after that. So let's finish with the payment here. I will just submit the last step and confirm my purchase information. There, we have submitted our order. Now, the last step is to generate the HAR file here, which is as simple as a right click and save all as HAR. So you want to do that, and it will be automatically saved in the download folder of Firefox, which is your computer download folder by default. If you don't know where that is, you can also go here and open the folder this way. Now, in the next tutorial, we'll have a look at how to import this and what we can do with this recording to make it more dynamic.